And thank you, Minister, for coming into the House and for all the work you are doing and your department is doing. And indeed, everybody on the Climate Action Committee, they're meeting daily. And it's great to see such energy and such cross-party consensus. And I suppose similar to how we all tried to suppress the virus, there's a kind of a political movement, I think, taking place where there's collective energy being applied to try and really take significant climate action, have this Dáil and this Seanad take significant climate action. And I think it's great. It's really encouraging. And I think it's a real encouragement for the young people who protested so many Fridays outside during the last Dáil. And it does give hope that we can achieve a just transition to a climate resilient and carbon neutral economy by 2050. I suppose I'm just going to limit my comments to three areas that I would like, Minister, you to consider. The first one is on energy, and I'm a member of the Joint Oireachtas Committee on Housing and Planning, and we've been engaging in the pre-legislative scrutiny of the Marine Planning and Development Bill, which you, of course, Minister, will be aware is a bill which will create a planning regulatory system for our marine territories. It will be a massive bill, but of huge importance for our state that we get this right. We have a huge opportunity in offshore wind energy. I had some appreciation of it, but as the pre-legislative scrutiny meetings have gone on, I've become much more aware. And not everybody in the House may know, but we as a small island have the offshore wind capacity to potentially generate 20% of Europe's renewable electricity. Now, that's an enormous potential opportunity. I'm not saying we're going to realise it all, but it is enormous. And it has been stated many times that no other single intervention can potentially deliver us as much renewable energy in one fell swoop. So it's great. I'm very supportive of it. And I believe we need to move the legislation through. I do have a concern, though, and that's around biodiversity with the bill and protecting the biodiversity. And I'm thinking, Minister, and I'd like your feedback on, when one of the first bills you brought to this House was the NORA bill, and that's where we are using funds from the oil industry and ring-fencing those funds for the Climate Action Fund. And I'm just wondering what your thoughts would be on creating some sort of a mechanism within the marine planning legislation to ring fence or apply some form of a levy to the industry, that those funds could be ring fenced then to invest in biodiversity and protecting biodiversity, marine biodiversity. The next two areas, Cathaoirleach, I'll move on briefly. Retrofitting, I fully recognise and commend the government for the $220 million that has been allocated for retrofitting, and I absolutely support the fact that the biggest chunk of money is going to low-income households. That is right. It is really important that everybody, but particularly those who need help most in upgrading their homes, would be supported by government. I am interested, though, Minister, to know, where is your department, or can you provide us with an update on the National Retrofit Office, which was promised, and specifically, I suppose, grants for middle-income earners as well. If we can help people have healthier, more sustainable homes, it will help both the individuals, but communities, and then our country. And finally, Minister, just in terms of public transportation and transportation generally, transport accounts for 20% of all our emissions, and 51% of them are coming from the private car. So we clearly need, and no place more so than in Dublin, do we need to get out of our cars. And while COVID-19 has emptied the streets of cars and it's become much more comfortable for cycling and walking, the bus transportation service, which has continued but at a reduced rate, I think also has become more important in Dublin commuters' minds. And if you could update us on the investment in buses. I know there was a commitment for, I think it was 100 hybrid buses, but I believe also a hydrogen bus has been trialled, and if we can get some update on that. And just in terms of the bus connects, it's a hugely ambitious project. And I support it. We need more affordable, accessible and reliable public bus services in the city. But we do also need to ensure, and I hear this particularly from around the county areas, and then in further out of the inner city estates, the local bus, the small little local bus service is hugely important for what you mentioned in your own opening remarks, the idea of a 15-minute communities and 15-minute cities. Those small little local bus services can be a lifeline for elderly people, but also for school-going children and for students. And increasingly, I think we should be ambitious for Dublin and people living in Dublin to not have to own a car. And to be able to primarily rely on public transport services. But to do that, obviously, we're going to need to increase the capacity and the operations of those bus services. And finally, Minister, the Royal Canal Greenway, we opened a stretch there from Spencer Dock up to Newcomen Bridge at Summerhill, North Strand, not Summerhill, North Strand. It's great, but you're probably not aware, but that has taken us 15 years. You know, the pace at which we're delivering those type of projects has to be accelerated. And I appreciate, because I was involved going back, you know, 15 years ago, we had to engage with Waterways Ireland, Irish Rail, CIE, Dublin City Council, the NTA, the Department of Transport, and they did, all the stakeholders came together. And they've done a superb job and delivered a superb infrastructure. All I suppose I'm saying is that we need to take the model and massively accelerate it. We've got a route from Spencer Dock all the way out to Athlone and beyond. Let's really bring the Greenway on the Royal Canal to life. It's a fantastic, sustainable infrastructure, and I would just encourage you, Minister, to, in your time in office, to do all you can to accelerate it.